Blessed are you in the name of God the Father, the Lord Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit. Today it is the 17th of November. We know the results of the votations of the cities here in Brazil, which is a great shame. People have voted mostly on governors, mayors of the left wing. It is clearly that people are putting more and more aside God. They don't wish to know of God. They are more voting. Also in the United States, they are voting for the left wing. It seems that God is telling, okay, if that is what you like, have it your way. It is a clear indication that we are approaching the rapture of the church and the start of the Great Tribulation. I will show you a video with already a man with the chip in his hand opening the door of his house, opening the drawers, using the chip in his hand. So have a look at that video.
Para entrar na minha casa, escaneio o meu chip.
Olha.
E a porta destranca.
Uhum.
Podemos
Muito
entrar.
Muito legal.
Você primeiro.
Obrigado. O que eu espero ver aqui ao vir na casa do Russ é vislumbrar o futuro. Até onde o Russ vai com isso? Aqui ele tem acesso em sua própria casa e como isso vai alterá-lo?
Essa aqui é a mesa de jantar da minha
certo.
Casa, que também funciona como um depósito operado pelo chip.
Nossa.
O que eu faço é escanear o meu chip aqui em cima. Aí tem uma dobradiça e aqui tá a galera.
Ah, que legal.
Esses dispositivos são as peças de tecnologia implantáveis que eu tenho.
Uhum.
E eu vou te mostrar o que eles fazem.
Fantástico.
Esse primeiro dispositivo é chamado de North Sense. Esse dispositivo é fixado ao corpo com piercings. Esse dispositivo vibra quando a pessoa se volta ao norte magnético e isso a transforma em uma bússola humana. E aqui temos alguns implantes magnéticos. Esse aqui é um pequeno chip revestido de gás de trítio e que brilha através da sua pele. E por ser um material radioativo, ele não é movido a bateria. Ele vai brilhar constantemente e tem uma meia-vida de 12 anos.
Bom, em que momento nós nos tornamos mais do que humanos no processo do transhumanismo?
Eu acho que nós sempre vamos querer superar a nossa humanidade básica, mas é importante apreciar a nossa humanidade existente. Não queremos perder o contato com isso.
We have all those prayers of believers, and it seems that it has no effect. It is God's plan of the Great Tribulation. We don't know how close we are. Here in Natal, we have inside the government buildings a room where they worship Satan and practice Macumba. So we don't need to be surprised that more and more we are approaching to that one government mondial, and that we are approaching the Great Tribulation. I also wish to read Ezekiel 8, verse 16. And the angel brought me into the inner court of the house of the Lord, that is the temple. And behold, at the door of the temple of the Lord, between the porch and the altar, were about 55 men with their backs to the temple of the Lord, and their faces toward the east, worshipping the sun towards the east. These men worshipping inside the temple, they are the leaders of Israel. They are worshipping not God, they are worshipping the sun. Then the angel said to me, have you seen this, O son of man? Is it too slight a thing for the house of Judah to commit the abominations which they commit here, that they should fill the land with violence and provoke me further to anger? Lo, they put the bronze to their nose. Therefore, I, that's God, will be in my watch. My eye will not spare, nor will I have pity. It is clear that here in Brazil, the United States, and also the countries in Europe, they are turning their back to God. The religious leaders, we don't know what they are doing. Some are doing the truth. They are worshiping God. But others, secretly, they are worshipping Satan and demons. People, they like to see, to speak. And that is exactly what is happening in worshipping demons, Satan. They are seeing Satanas. They are seeing and speaking to demons. That's what people like. People don't like a God who speaks through the Bible, who speaks through prayer to God, but there is no real communication, no real false talking, there is no seeing. And that is all about the Christian faith. So we are approaching the Great Tribulation. We can't deny it with that video of the ship in the hand. It is clear that we are close to the Great Tribulation. There's no denial. You can't say, oh, we still have tens of years, centuries. No, the signs are there very clearly that we are at the final time, that we are approaching, and we are seeing the things which are described in Revelation. So be aware. We are all now, like I said, in the ticking, the clock of God is ticking. We are all diagnostic with a fatal a mortal disease, we are all dying. We all have excretions, only a very short time to live. We can't deny that. Only those Christians who put aside, who don't have any Bible knowledge, who are deaf and blind, shut their eyes, they don't wish to know, they are the foolish versions of Matthew 25, who will stay behind and go through the great tribulations. And how long they will be living there, I don't know. If they will continue to live, if they have the force to refuse the mark 666, and we are seeing already here in Brazil that you are forced to take the vaccination. In Sicilia, you are forced to take the test of COVID. If not, you are put into the concentration camps where you will stay. So, taking your children from you, already there is the dictatura. We are seeing already the approximation of Satan in the great tribulation of the Antichrist. So, what will we do? Well, we need to go to Galatians, starting with verse 16. But I say, walk by the Spirit, and do not gratify the desires of the flesh. For the desires of the flesh are against the Spirit, and the desires of the Spirit are against the flesh. For these are opposed to each other, to prevent you from doing what you should do. But if you are led by the Spirit, you are not under the law. Now, the works of the flesh are plain: immorality, impurity, licentiousness, idolatry, sorcery, enmity, strife, jealousy, anger, selfishness, dissension, party spirit, envy, drunkenness, carousing, and the like. If you recognize this in your life, you need to think very seriously. Perhaps you are part of those foolish versions who will stay behind and go through the great tribulation. You may say, Wilfred, but we are not living under the law. Jesus Christ brought us free from the law. Is it? Didn't Jesus Christ came to earth to fulfill the law? And we are pleasing God through the power of the Holy Spirit by doing the law. Jeremiah and Ezekiel are very clear that the word of God is over Israel because they abandon the mandamentals, the days of God. They put aside all the commandments of the law, all things which God had commanded the Israelites to do, to live to the glory of God. And that is exactly what we are seeing nowadays. People, they don't wish to know about the laws of God, nor the laws of their country. Murder. If you don't give your mobile phone, they kill you. They put a gun to your head. The many robbers driving to the red traffic light, no respect anymore for any law. We are living in the time of the lawlessness. This is already predicted in Timotheus. And here in Galatians 5, we are seeing what are the wickedness of men. So, if you recognize these things in your life, think well if you don't belong to the foolish virgins who will stay behind. Verse 21, I warn you, as I warned you before, that those who do such things shall not inherit the kingdom of God. They will not be taken into heaven. Verse 22, but the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. Against such there is no law. If you are practicing sex without being married, having sex with various girls, women, sure, I'm not practicing self-control. If you are having sex with more than one woman outside the marriage, that's adultery. And if you don't stop with it and confess your sin, you will not inherit the kingdom of God. Wilfred, but you are wrong. I have the dons of the Holy Spirit. I'm speaking in tongues, prophetizing. But Matthew Stafford is very clear. God, Jesus Christ, will say, I do not know you, and the door to heaven is shut. So you need to examine if you belong to those wise virgins. Let's look again. Do you recognize these? Those speaking in tongues, prophetizing, that might be dons of the Holy Spirit, but that doesn't tell you if you are a wise virgin and you will be taken into heaven at the rapture of the church. So let's examine if you belong to those who will be taken into heaven. Do you recognize? Your love is seen by believers and unbelievers. There is joy, there is peace, there is patience. There are patience with unbelievers, with other people, with believers, people you don't like. You are calm. It's the kindness, goodness, where you're helping your brothers and sisters. All those unbelievers who are in social needs, goodness in giving your tithe, your gifts, are you helping in the church? Are you helping to even to proclaim the gospel? Are you praying for the missionaries? Are you praying with perseverance? Are you using the sword of God, the Bible, in your fight against Satan? It's the faithfulness, it's the persistence in praying, in reading the Bible, it's the faithfulness in opening yourself to the Holy Spirit, gentleness, self-control. If one is mocking you, you think you remain calm? It's the self-control. Also in your sexual life, if your child is provoking you, you remain calm. So self-control in eating, or are you fat? So self-control, no addiction to drugs, alcohol, smoking. Against this, there is no law. They are fully under the control of the Holy Spirit. If you recognize these points, then be sure you will fail like I fail. And I need to confess my sins. I'm still a sinner. But if you are recognizing these points, you may reckon yourself under the wise virgins. You are striving for these points. So please take this to heart, because we don't know how much time we still have left to the great tribulation and the rapture of the church. My wife, she thinks we still have 2 years, but with all what is going on with the elections in Brazil, the elections in the United States, the COVID, the vaccination, the ship in the hand, which is already there, we don't need to make ourselves any illusions. So, we have left the doctor who has told us that we only have a few time to live. Take it serious. This is no joking. Take things seriously. Are you going to marry? Anxious to marry? Or are you anxious to proclaim the gospel, to put your time for God? Are you anxious to buy a house? Are you anxious for those worldly things? You're rushing to have a baby, to get pregnant? Or are you anxious and aware of what is going on in the world? If that ideologia, the gender ideologia, are you aware? Or are you taking the signs, the signals seriously? And are you preparing yourself to be taken into heaven? Thank you, God the Father, and Jesus Christ, and Holy Spirit, that you have revealed what is going on and warned us, so that we don't need to be surprised. If you are not a Christian yet, if you haven't accepted Jesus Christ, take this sign seriously and accept Jesus Christ as your Savior and Lord. Go, Christians, live under the control of the Holy Spirit and take everything seriously. And prepare yourself to be taken at the first coming of Jesus Christ into heaven. Holy Spirit, help me to examine myself and tell me what is wrong in my life. Help me so that I will not be left at the rapture of the church, and I need to go and pass through the great tribulation. Help me. In Jesus' name I ask you. Amen.